conference will now be recorded.
Okay, means over Azure portal. Oh, you have idea about the Azure portal. You are able to create a virtual machine and also modify, adding storage part and all, right?
Yeah, correct.
So basically,
this is
what
about
I'm planning.
This is about me. I don't know about others. You can ask others.
No problem. So actually, I'm planning to give you the information related to the Azure Administrator certification. I hope you know that I'm talking about the Azure AG104 certification. So basically, AG103 become now AG104, right? And if you're talking about the course content of AG104, so you should know about the Active Directory. The main content of AG104 is basically related to the, I'm going to show you. So this is the course content related to the AG104. Yeah, please tell me.
Yeah, Manjit, Satish here. So I just want to, you know, about the agenda of this call, will you going to walk through the template as well as the course content, or what we are going to see here?
Have you checked my
yes, I have gone through it. So it's saying that about one AZ104 course content and online class for 2 hours. So I see the course content for AZ104. It's a vast what I can say. So we cannot cover most of the things in 2 hours, what I believe. I may be wrong. So are we going to cover a few of the topics here, or entire the 104 topics here?
How many topics we are able to cover in next 2 hour? Is it possible to cover the entire content of AG104?
No, that's what I'm saying. So I believe no.
Only 4 topic. I'll just give you the information related to the how you can start prepare yourself over for AG104 certification.
Okay, that sounds good. Okay.
So our agenda to understand about firstly, if some candidate are new related to the cloud technology, so we'll give up to 15 to 20 minutes to describe about the activity of cloud, and then we'll move into the portal and start work directly with the help of portal. And
okay.
Agenda of this class, I'll show you what is Azure Active Directory and how we can manage AD objects, like as a creating a user, invite user, create a bulk user, and also we'll discuss about customized domain, and we'll also connect our Azure Active Directory with on-premises Windows 10 operating system. This is our agenda. Aldo, next.
Okay,
if
sounds good.
If we're talking about the purpose of this particular class, so it's just, you know, that each and everyone can work like this, but I'm not running any organization. I'm working with one of MNC in Delhi location. So as a technical trainer, as a tech lead, so I'm not working with any organization. I'm not working with any institute, not organization, any institute. So basically, this is the YouTube promotion, you can say that. Actually, I have I hope you see in the mail, Teach Me Cloud is my YouTube channel.
Yeah,
and I start creating a video for the AG104. So in this class, you are able to understand only 4 topics. But if you subscribe my channel, if you go through the playlist, you are able to see I'm planning to create up to 35 video, and these 35 video can help you to crack your examination definitely 100%. Because if you check, I have already uploaded 2 different video. And in the videos, I have already covered the topic of manage Azure Active Directory. Just go through and check it. I'll describe the each and everything by using my pay as you go account. So definitely, if you're giving your 1.5 month, 100% you will clear your examination without any help.
Okay, so that sounds good to start. Yep. Yeah, sounds good to start.
Okay. So as
sorry to
yeah, please, you. Please tell me. Please tell me.
Will you able to show us the AD connectors? How do you sync the accounts from on-premises?
Yep. Sure. Oh,
thank you.
No problem. That's why I established my entire setup for you only for the practical purpose. I don't have an idea related how to teach with the help of PPT. Although I have a total experience, but I never use PPT. So that's why I created my entire setup on my Windows laptop. So this is our Windows laptop. I have created one Active Directory on the on-premises, and this is my Windows 10 operating system and 12 operating system. So we will make a connection with our Azure Active Directory user. We'll connect with our Windows 10 operating system. And as per your requirement, I'll also show you how we can use Azure AD Connect. And I hope you know that with the help of Azure AD Connect, you are able to synchronize your entire on-premises user to Office 365 portal or Azure portal. So this is our agenda. I'm just going to start. Have you any question related to the Azure, anyone?
Hi, Manjit. It's Akram.
Yeah. Akram.
Oh, Manjit, are you also give an idea of migrations?
Migration is a big topic, but I have a good idea related to the migration. I did up to 10 to 15 projects related to the migration, app migration, database migration, server migration. No worry.
And all these videos are in YouTube, your YouTube channel?
Not now. I just created. Actually, you will be get up to 25-30 video related to the AG103, and I just started to create our AG104 certification. So till now I uploaded I think 3 or 4 video related to the series of AG104, but within 20 to 25 days you will be get the entire video.
So you are uploading all the videos from the starting, right? From the scratch.
Yep. From this guy, you can check. I'm just each and every video without skip. Means if you open my video and open your Azure portal, definitely you will be follow the entire step and you will be get the result.
Okay. Thank you.
Manjit, anyone here?
Yeah.
Prithvi here. So I just want to check with you: is AZ104 is available in India to take the exam, or it's still in the beta version?
It's a beta version. Yeah.
Okay, great.
Due to COVID-19, it's some problem with certification and examination. I hope you know that right now you are able to take your examination by self. Just you need to arrange your 2 different laptop, right?
Yeah, but there are a lot of constraints that I'm hearing from a lot of people that they were unable to take the exam because of the peers and connectivity issues and all.
Yep, but you need to just arrange your 2 high configuration, minimum 4 GB of RAM based laptop, and internet speed should be a 20 Mbps.
Okay.
So you, Pearson View team can manage, can install the required software and create a server for the examination by using the TeamViewer or any remote tool. So it's a separate thing. If you have a doubt, I'll describe you.
How can you
prepare yourself for examination? How can start your examination by self? So yeah, I'm just going to start from scratch because it's really good thing that most of guys have good experience related to the virtualization and cloud. And I really happy that you are putting these types of questions like as a migration, as a ready connect, and also related to the AG103, AG104 certification. So I hope most of guys has good experience in cloud. So it's a really good thing. But as you know that in our class, we have, I think, around 18 people. So I don't think entire 18 people have good experience in Azure. So Azure cloud technology, that's why I'm planning to describe you from the zero level, from the scratch. And I just need only 20 minutes to describe about the cloud computing. And after that, we'll move into the cloud portal and start our content, start with our agenda. Is it okay now? Any question about anyone? Have
okay.
any question? Okay. So, So, as per the name of what cloud computing, so I hope you know about it, cloud computing. So, basically, you can say that the meaning of cloud computing is just types of technology, right? So, like as a Cisco is a technology, Microsoft is a technology, Python, Java, HTML, .NET, these all are the technology. And by using the technology, you are able to perform some tasks. If we're talking about the Cisco, so Cisco is fully related to the network devices or security devices. If we're talking about the router, switches, firewalls, so you know about the entire things are considered in the Cisco devices. If we're talking about the server operating system, Active Directory, DHCP, DNS, so these all are the part of Microsoft devices, Microsoft technologies. So like that, the cloud computing is also types of technology that can give you a platform. And by using the cloud computing platform, you are able to perform any task related to the development, related to the architect and administration part as well. So it's an open platform. You need to sign up yourself over a cloud platform and you can start work for your organization, for your business, for yourself as well. So for better understanding, I'm just going to categorize our cloud computing in two different parts. You can say that the first one is work-based and another is technology-based. So it's just only for the understanding purpose, I'm categorized it into two different parts. So the meaning of work-based, as per the name, means which types of work you want with the help of cloud technology. So work-based in the sense you can say that I hope you know about infrastructure as a service, software as a service, and I hope you know about the platform as a service. So these three parts are considered as a work-based. And if you're talking about the technology-based, so in the technology-based, we will discuss about the public cloud, and we'll discuss about the private cloud, and final, we'll discuss about hybrid technology. So cloud is categorized in two different parts, work-based and technology-based. So in the work-based, just try to understand about the meaning of infrastructure as a service, software as a service, and platform as a services. So I hope you know that, but I'm just going to describe about the infrastructure. So you can say that infrastructure as a service is also called manageable service. The meaning of manageable service means customer, user can manage each and everything by self. For example, you just purchase a one virtual machine with the help of Azure, with the help of Google Cloud or Amazon Web Services. And when you purchase your virtual machine, the configuration of your VM is 4 GB of RAM, 2 core of CPU, server 2012 operating system with 100 GB of hard drive. After 10 days, after 15 days, you are planning to change the configuration. You are planning to change the RAM size, and you are planning to change the hard disk size. So you have option to do that by self. Means those types of services which is available on portal, not only the Azure, any portal. Those types of services are available on portal, and under the services, you can modify as per your requirement. Means you are able to manage it. These all services consider as a infrastructure as a service. If we're talking about the example, so all virtual machines, storage, networking, security, backup and restore, and migration. So these all are the services which is count in the infrastructure as a services. Because if you plan to configure these types of activity, you need to manage each and everything by self. So if user can establish the entire environment for the organization, so these all services count as infrastructure as services. Is it okay? Any question about the infrastructure as services? Anyone?
We are good, Manjit.
Thank you. Next, software as a service. So I hope you know about the software as a services. So software as a services, we have a good example related to the SaaS. So as per the name of software as a services, it'd be talking about the example of SaaS, Office 365. O365 is basically a best example for software as a services, because if you're talking about the mailing services, if you talk about your mailing services before 7 to 8 years, what you need to do, you need to establish your Exchange server on premises. You need to create a two server, one server for the Active Directory, one server for the Exchange server. You need to install Exchange server in another machine and create your user from Active Directory and configure your user as a mailbox in your office, in your Exchange server. But right now, no need to establish any kind of hardware. You need to purchase your domain from godaddy.com or HostGator or Namecheap, anywhere. You just need to purchase your domain name and associate your domain name with Office 365 account and create your mailboxes, create your user as per your licensing. Which types of license you purchase over Office 365 portal. and within 10 minutes, within 15 minutes, you are able to start your mailing services. If you have a Office 365 account, if you have purchased your domain from anywhere, domain from godaddy.com, you need to associate both and create your user and start your mailing services. If you compare the software as a services with on-premises, what you need to do, you need to give up to one full day, up to 8 to 10 hours to establish and configure your offline Exchange server. Means I'm talking about on-premises Exchange server, because you need to configure each and everything by self, by using your on-premises hardware. But here, no need to use any kind of hardware. You just need to open the Office 365 portal and sign up yourself and purchase a license and create your user and start using your mailing services directly with the help of portal. So this is the example of our software as a services. And next, if you're talking about a platform as a services, so we can say that the platform as a services is also called unmanageable services. Unmanageable services in the sense user or customer are unable to manage each and everything. 75% activity handled by the cloud provider and 25% activity handled by the customer who working over a Azure portal or cloud AWS portal. So we have a lot of example related to the platform as a services, like as a web application, like as a load balancer, like as a Azure database services. So these all are the example related to the platform as a services. So if you're talking about the meaning of web application, for example, you are planning to host your website, you are planning to deploy your website with the help of Azure portal. So you created your website with the help of .NET, PHP, Java, any language, any code. You just created your website in, for example, PHP. So you have a data in your pen drive or external hard drive, and you are planning to host your website and try to associate your website with a domain name. So you have a two different way to do that. One with the help of infrastructure as a services, and another with the help of platform as a services. If you're talking about the infrastructure as a services, means you need to purchase one Ubuntu machine, you need to install Apache services, you need to configure SQL database, every activity you need to perform manually. And you need to give up to 3 to 4 hours to establish your entire server. Still associate your server to the domain name. If you are moving yourself with the help of infrastructure as a services, but if you want to execute, if you want to host your website with the help of platform as a services, what you need to do? You need to purchase one web server, one web services, web application services with the help of platform as a services. Create your web app, upload your file with the help of FTP or FileZilla. Within 15 minutes, you are able to host your website, and you can also associate your website with your own domain name. So that is the difference between the infrastructure and platform as a services. Each and every platform managed by the provider, you need to just create and upload your data. Data in the sense your website, you need to upload your website. So, and load balancer, you know that if you are hosting your e-commerce website, and unfortunately, number of hits are occurred over a website. So for the managed purpose, to manage the environment, you need to create a load balancer. And by using the load balancer services, you can establish that server in the backend of load balancer and each and every load managed by the LB. And like that, another option in platform as a services is Azure databases. So in case of Azure database, you know that if you have configured your SQL server on-premises or Oracle server on-premises, and you are planning to connect your on-premises database to Azure portal, so with the help of Azure database services, with the help of Azure SQL services, you can just make a connectivity between both. And also you can migrate your on-premises database and put it into the Azure database services. So this is the basic information related to the cloud computing, especially in the case of work-based. So now, have you any question related to the workbase, like is infrastructure, software, and platform services? Anyone?
No, Manjit, I'm good with. You can go ahead.
Fine. What about other?
Yes,
we are good. Yeah, good to go. Good to go.
Next, try to understand about the technology base. So this is the work. This is the purpose that you are planning to move yourself, move your organization into the cloud portal. But how you can implement? So we have a three different way to implement these types of activity. One, public in the sense, publicly open for each and everyone, like as a Azure, AWS, GCP, and I hope you know about the Alibaba as well. So these are the cloud provider. These are all are the big cloud provider, and you can establish your infrastructure as a services, software as a services, and platform as a services with the help of these public cloud provider. Yeah, anyone want to say something?
In public cloud, this Salesforce comes in public cloud or private cloud?
Salesforce is a basically a CRM based technology. You can say that the cloud technology, you can say that it's a cloud technology, but basically it's a CRM based a portal. You can manage your activity, you can manage your organization activity with the help of Salesforce. Okay.
Yes.
And next, if you're talking about the platform as a services, so in the case of platform as a services, you can say that VMware, OpenStack, Hyper-V. So these all are the tools that can help you to configure and create your private in private cloud. Although you have option to purchase services privately with the help of AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud as well. But you can say that these services are considered as a dedicated services, are dedicated host, dedicated machines. And next, if we're talking about the hybrid, so hybrid is basically a combination of both public plus private. Like if you are using some services in your environment, so you are using some services with the help of a VMware or hypervisor or OpenStack, and you are planning to purchase some services from public cloud, like from AWS or Azure, and you want to make a connection between each other. So this is called hybrid, means combination of both. And up to 75% organization are using hybrid technology. The best example of hybrid technology, as you know, that Azure AD Connect. So Azure AD Connect is the best example of hybrid technology. So this is the basic information related to the cloud computing, who new in cloud technology. So I hope you understand about the activity, how we can start our work over Azure or AWS or Google Cloud. So just check it within 1 minute. And if you have a doubt or question, please let me know.
Manjit, I have a question here.
Yep.
So in the virtualization behind the Azure, is hypervisor is used or some other technology is used?
No one can disclose, although they all are using VMware, OpenStack, and Hyper-V, but they never disclose. No anyone disclose, like as GCP, Azure, Google Cloud, Alibaba.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome. Any question, Baba?
Manjit, when you say that Azure AD Connect is a hybrid cloud, so does that mean it is using public and private combo, or it's using a public and on-premise combination?
Yeah, on-premises is also considered as a private, because you
are Azure AD Connect, which is using.
Pardon.
Like in Azure AD Connect, so which combination is being used?
Because you are using your on-premises Active Directory.
Okay.
In the we're talking about on-premises, you are using the Active Directory on your local office, and you can synchronize your Active Directory user with your Azure portal as well as your Office 365 portal.
Okay. So how about with private private and public combination for on-premises for AD?
So this is the our machine which is implemented that you implemented on on-premises. This is the private.
Oh, so generally Active Directory is implemented even on private clouds?
Private cloud, you can say that the on-premises is also considered as a private. Those types of resources you implemented in your organization, like you establish a SAN, storage area network, and you are planning to share your local SAN with Azure portal. So this is the combination of your private and public as well.
Okay. So because when you say that Azure has a private cloud as well, so does that mean like when we buy a custom domain and we integrate that into our Azure cloud, does that mean it becomes as a private cloud or it becomes a private network?
Exactly. For you have option to customize your domain and you want to configure each and activity by self. You don't want to use the any services, any default services of Azure. You are planning to do each and everything by self. These activities also considered as a private cloud.
Oh, so if I buy a custom cloud and if I integrate that with the Azure, then it becomes a private cloud and it doesn't become a public cloud, right?
Yeah, it's a private cloud. Only the Azure can give you the option of Azure work just like a mediator.
Okay.
Azure act just like a mediator. Another example of Azure act as a private cloud. So as we know that Azure can give you option to purchase virtual machines. You can purchase your server operating system, Linux operating system, right? So we have two different way to purchase the servers. One, by using the default services, by using the on-demand option, and another, you can purchase your server by using the option of dedicated. So you have option to purchase the dedicated host as well. So once you purchase a dedicated host and you planning to create your virtual machine over your own dedicated machine, dedicated host, so you are using the private services of Azure. But the dedicated machine is much costly in compare of on-demand.
Okay. So when we say about virtual network, so is that a private network or it's a private cloud on which we deploy?
No. These services is considered as a cloud. Private or public. These services are considered.
Okay.
So when you create your VNet on VNet over Azure portal, so VNet is a service which is provided by the Azure and it's available for each and everyone. Means publicly it is available. When you configure your on, when you establish your on, it means that you are doing the activity for personal usage only, for personal organization only.
Okay.
So you can say that it's a Azure stack in the sense combination of both public and private, combination of on-premises and cloud technology. So that is considered as a Azure stack.
Okay. That means it's a hybrid cloud.
Yeah, we can say hybrid cloud.
Okay, got it.
What about other? Any question from other side? Yep.
Manjit, this is Koti. I am new to cloud computing actually. So what is on-premises?
Meaning on-premises means your. Are you connected with your laptop or mobile phone?
Mobile, sir.
Do you have laptop and desktop as well, I think?
Yeah, I'm having.
Okay, so laptop or desktop?
I'm having laptop.
So your laptop is on-premises. Your laptop or desktop that you have, these all are called on-premises. Means you establish, for example, you install your Windows 10 operating system in your laptop or Windows 7 operating system in your laptop. So it means that you are installing OS in your on-premises device. Physical device.
You mean private things, right? On-premises means.
You can say that private.
It's your own premises.
It's like your local machines.
Okay, any local machine, any local resource.
Okay.
Mobile phone, server, laptop. Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
So this is the information related to the cloud computing. And next, I'm going to describe you another option. Like Koti, you are new with cloud technology. So that's why I need to give 10 more minutes to understand how you can start work with Azure portal. So just allow me a 10 minute, and after that we'll work directly over Azure portal and show you our agenda. So the next, start working with Azure. So what you need to do, as we know that Azure is a basically a public cloud. So what you need to do, if you want to perform the task with the help of Azure portal, what you need to do, you just need to sign up yourself. Portal.azure.com. This is our URL. In the first step, you need to create account by using your mail ID, your credit card, and mobile number also required. And it will be debit up to 2 rupees from your credit card for verification. And it will be return you within next 24 hours. This is the prerequisite. You can say that this is the basic requirement to create your, to sign up yourself over Azure portal. And if you're talking about the account type or subscription type, which is available on Azure, so we have a two different way to sign up ourselves. One, as we are planning to create our account for the training purpose only, so you can create your free trial account. And second, you have option to create your pay as you go account. Now, so if you're talking about the free trial account, you need, whenever you sign up, you need, you will be get 13,300 rupees or $200, right? And the amount is valid for next 30 days. And total validity of your account is 12 months, sorry. So this is the information related to the free trial account. If we're talking about the pay as you go, so as for the name, pay for each services, pay as per your requirement. Any question?
Manjit. In pay as you go model, what are the services you are using actually? To, you know, because it taking a lot of money in the pay as you go. So what type of basic storage or the VM size you are using?
Every services you can use. If you move yourself with the help of free trial and pay as you go, you are able to use any services.
Yeah, pay as you go. No, I'm talking about what you are using actually.
I'm using for the training purpose or for the organization purpose?
Organization purpose or the training purpose? Like as you said, your videos, you're making a videos in pay as you go model, right?
Yep. I'm using my pay as you go account from last 3 years.
Okay, so in that pay as you go, what are the services you are using actually? VMs, creating VM or taking a VM storage, what type of storage you are taking.
Actually I'm provide online training for various vendor like as IntelliPad, LearnFly, Online IT Group, CloudThat, Apex Services. So I'm provide online training for these types of vendors. So I'm able to take the classes of architect and admin both part, AG300 and 301, AG103 and AG104 as well. So it's depend upon the content. For example, I have a two different batch and both batch related to the admin part for AG103. So what I need to do, I need to create a virtual machine. I need to manage the networking part, storage part, active directory services, some activity related to the network like express router and VPN. So in if I'm trying to purchase these types of services, so I need to pay up to approximately 1500 to 2500 rupees per month only.
And this is only for VM?
Not only for VM,
only for VM.
Including the entire services. It's not only for VM. Oh. I'm using backup services. I'm using the disaster services, VPN, ExpressRoute, Gateway, and all services.
And after doing all these labs, you are deleting the resources, right?
Same time. After completing the practical, if candidate say, sir, everything is okay, then I'm going to delete all. If you forget your services and you just forget for the 15, just the 5 to 7 days, you need to pay extra amount.
Correct.
So that's why you need to start yourself by using the free trial. And after that, when you have a confidence related to the portal and portal services, then you can move yourself with pay as you go.
Okay, got it, Manjit. Thank you.
So Manjit, Kranti here. I have a question. So is it on hourly basis billing or how it is?
Yep, it's hourly basis. Pay as you go. Means if you are using 10 minutes, you need to pay amount for 10 minutes. It's depend upon how many, how much time you are using the services duration. It's depend upon the services duration.
Manjit, I have a question.
Any question here. About any? Yeah, please.
Are you able to set any type of alerts if your VM usage goes beyond your computing hours that trigger your mail or a text message?
You have option to configure your you can say that alert that is called budget alert. Yes, you can do that. You just decide I'm able to pay 1500 rupees only in entire month. You can just set your budget for 1500 and no need to pay extra amount. Once you completed your 1500, you will be get an alert.
Manjit, one more question I have. Like this is a part of like training and all. Okay. What you know the big companies do actually when they use the Azure? They don't even delete a single VM or a resource or resource group, anything. So how they manage? They you know go with the pay as you go or how?
So most of organization are using MSDN account, sometime for MSDN account and pay as you go. Only two different types of account are used by the organization.
So if I have to add to Manjit's point, so for the big organizations or the Fortune 500 companies that we have, I mean, we do have multiple subscriptions basically like enterprise agreement, cloud service provider. We do have Azure sponsorship accounts. We do have certain exceptional Correct. Accounts. So most of the Correct. Big shots will be going with enterprise agreement subscriptions where they will be getting a lot of benefits. Why? Because they are the most revenue generators for the Microsoft, right? So they will be going with enterprise agreement. Yeah.
Exactly. What happened? It's a types of business. You can say that cloud is a types of business. So Azure and Google Cloud and Amazon team can coordinate with the organization for coordinate with a big organization. Marketing team, sales team, just coordinate with the organization and give the lot of option related to the subscription types. So it's a types of marketing strategy, means it's depend upon the organization. It's depend upon the value of organization. Microsoft help you a lot related to the subscription. So right now we are just talking about how you can start to work with Azure portal. In the organization is a separate thing. Organization can manage and provide you the subscription type. You need to just log in yourself and start your work. But if you plan to start your work with Azure personally, so what you need to do, you have a two different way to start your work. This is pay as you go and another is free trial account. Is it okay now?
Yeah, got it.
Fine. So have you any question related to the account types? And if we're talking about the sign up ourselves, so I hope you all of you know about how you can sign up yourself over Azure portal. Although if you have a doubt, if you have a question, please let me know. Anyone?
No, Anjit, let's go ahead with that. So if anyone has doubt, they'll probably pitch in and they'll clear those doubts at the moment.
Okay, fine. So I'm just going to show you the agenda. What's our agenda? So as per the planning, we just try to understand about the contents related to the AG104. So if you plan to clear your examination of AG104, so what you need to do? This is the area I hope you know about. You can just directly download course content from docs.microsoft.com. You just need to open your Google and just type exam Azure AG104 and just click on the Microsoft link and download the content. So if you plan to prepare yourself, what you need to, which types of topic you need to cover. So you need to understand about the Azure Active Directory services. And the identity and governance give you 15% to 20% of question in your real examination. And second, implementing and managing the storage. In the storage part, you should know about how we can manage the storage account and access key, manage key, implement the storage replication by using the LRS, RAGRS, GRS and all. And in the storage, you also know about the export import job. And also you have good, you need to know about the Azure Storage Explorer, how you can manage it. And another option, it's related to the compute part. In the compute part can give you up to 25 to 30% question in your final examination. What you need to learn in this panel, you need to know about the high availability, deploy and configure the SQL set. You can also say that VMSS services, manage the virtual machine with the help of ARM template, configure your VHD template and also deploy your template. Configure the virtual machine, hard disk encryption, resize the VM, data adding disk, configure the network part and redeploy the virtual machine. So these are the content that you need to cover in case of deploying and manage the Azure compute resources. And next we'll be talking about the another. So this is the networking part. So in networking part, you need to understand VNet pairing, also manage the IP addressing, network routes, interface, subnetting and virtual network environment as well. Manage the DNS, customize the DNS, NSG, network security group, firewall, and configure your deployment, DDoS attack protection, application security, WAP as well. Need to know about the application gateway, normal network gateway, load balancing, public load balancing, and troubleshooting the LB part as well. And you need to know about the monitoring the virtual network environment. And last, you need to know about the monitor and backup resources. So this is the agenda if you plan to cover your examination of AG104. So this is the topics that you need to know. So it's depend upon how much time you are giving over your portal. So if you plan to clear your examination related to the AG104, so it's fully depend upon you how much time you are giving over Azure portal, because no any dumps can help you. Dumps can help you to clear the examination, but it cannot be improve your skill. So that's why you need to try to sign up yourself and create your Azure portal, free trial account over Azure, and just start your activity directly over Azure portal. Any doubt, any question?
You are covering each and every point in your YouTube channel.
Yep. That's why I'm trying to give you up to 30 to 35 video related to the AG104 certification.
Thank you.
Welcome. Did you subscribe my channel?
I'm going to subscribe your channel after this class.
Thank you.
Raut, can you tell me your name of the subscribe channel?
Yeah, it's a Teach Me Cloud. I have already sent that link in our mail.
Okay, fine. Okay, Raut, I will check that.
Thank you. So definitely you will be clear your examination. I'm going to show you the agenda of my videos. So this is my channel. I hope you are able to see it. So we need to click on the playlist. So this is the AG104 certification. It's a playlist. You need to click on the playlist. And right now, I think I have uploaded only two or three videos, just started to upload.
Okay, Rahul. I will check that one. No issues.
Okay, fine. So you just need to follow the video. You need to just go through the video, and meanwhile, you need to open your Azure portal and follow the step according to the video, and definitely you will be clear your examination. So I think the three videos are uploaded. 1, 2, 3 video uploaded. So you can check when you have a time.
Sure, Rahul. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Welcome. And as for the agenda, I'm planning to describe you about the information, how you can use your Azure Active Directory, right? So I'm connected. This is our Azure portal, and I'm using my pay-as-you-go account. So this is the subscription type. So I have already purchased three different subscriptions. These all are the pay-as-you-go subscription. So you are able to perform the entire task by using your pay as you go. Just you need to know about how many services running currently running your environment. You need to delete your entire services if you don't have a use. And next, if we're talking about class agenda, so we'll try to understand about creating user group, managing the property of user, and also configure the MFA. And we'll also show you how you can customize your on domain with Azure Active Directory. Okay, so I'm going to show you step by step how you can start your work with the Azure portal, especially with Azure Active Directory services. So I hope you are able to see my Azure portal. So this, you just need to click, you have a two different part, left, and this is the left panel, and another is right. So in the left panel, you need to click security option. Under the security, you have a Azure Active Directory. Just click on the Azure Active Directory. So I hope you have idea about Active Directory. So I'm not talking about the Azure Active Directory. I'm just talking about the only the Active Directory services, which is available in server operating system. So do you have an idea about the AD? I'm talking about the Azure normal Windows Active Directory. Anyone?
Yes.
Okay.
Go. I have an idea on the Azure Active Directory, but not on the local Active Directory as such.
Oh, okay, great. Okay, so in the local Active Directory, could you please explain me why we need to use the local AD?
To manage users.
Not the entire content can be put into the cloud AD. So whatever is the data that we, it is like the entire user base, I would say, is stored in the local AD, and whatever is required to the cloud for the authentication or authorization purposes, we sync those through multiple mechanisms like password hash authentication or something else. So through that, we sync it into the cloud so that we can leverage the required things in the Azure cloud.
You're talking about the on-premises AD or Azure cloud AD?
I'm talking about Azure AD, like how we sync the data from on-premise to Azure.
Okay, so we just want to know about the on-premises AD.
On the on-premises AD, but I can say that there are the resources on your network, and you want to assign certain permissions to the objects. Active Directory treats everything as an object, whether is it a computer, user, or a printer, or any resource. It's an object, and these are assigned the permissions. Using those permissions, they are being authenticated and authorized in an AD environment. An AD is a kind of a database.
Exactly. Means you can also say that Active Directory is a service which is available in server operating system. And by using the AD, by using the Active Directory, you are able to control your objects, right? You can create a, you can install your Active Directory on premises and connect your client machine to Active Directory services. and create a user from AD and log in with the help of your client machine as well. Then you can create attributes for your client machine and manage the all.
Okay.
Clear? So, but if you're talking about, so actually directly can perform the same task, the difference between on-premises to cloud. So cloud can give you a lot of options in compare of on-premises. So basically the cloud, Azure Active Directory can give you option to manage your on-premises AD, manage your on-premises client machine, manage your application and resources that you purchase over Azure portal. You can also create a multiple tenant to use your Azure portal services. So in this part, I'm trying to describe you about the some contents related to the AD, not entire, like as a, this is our Azure Active Directory. And in the Azure Active Directory, we have a lot of options are available. User groups, identities, role and administrator, and Azure AD Connect also available, MDM, MAM, custom domain as well. So just start work with the users.
So Manjit, although I have a question here, sorry to interrupt you. So the on-premises uses the Kerberos mechanism to authenticate the user. Does cloud also, Azure also uses the Kerberos, or does it use another?
Exactly,
mechanism?
Because security is required to make a connection between each other.
So you are saying whenever that cloud is also using Kerberos?
Yep. If you make a connection between your on-premises to cloud with the help of Azure AD Connect, so these types of content, these types of protocol can work to make a connectivity between each other.
Got it. Thank you.
Welcome. So if you're talking about the users, so in the user, I have already created a multiple user. Some users are connected with on-premises, some user connected with my own domain. So like this one, elearningplace.in is my domain that I purchased from godaddy.com, and synchronized with win something. This is my on-premises AD that I installed on my local machine. And if we're talking about class at the rate manan.rawat24@24gmail.onmicrosoft, so this is the default domain. So firstly, just try to understand about how to create a user. So we have a multiple way to create our user. Like as you, if you want to create a single user, you need to click here. If you want to create a multiple user, you need to click on the create bulk user. So create bulk user in the sense, for example, in your organization or in your local organization have a thousands of users or 100 users, and you are planning to create entire user in single click. So what you need to do, you need to click on the create user and upload your CSV file. If you don't have a format, just download the format and fill the entire information. This is the format of your CSV file. You need to add username, like I'm going to use XYZ. This is the display name, XYZ at your domain name. What's your domain name? You type to your domain name. This is the panel for password, and this is the login activity. You want to log in it? Yes, we want. And once you configure the entire details in the CSV file, you need to just upload. You need to select here and upload your data, upload your CSV file from on-premises. And you will be see, once your files uploaded successfully, you will be get the entire user details in the panel of user. So I'm going to show you how we can create a user, single user. So this is the option. You need to click on the user. We have a two different options. One is create, another is invite. So as per the name, we have a two option, create user and new guest user. So create user in the sense you are planning to create a fresh user. And if you're talking about the guest, you have already using the services. By using, you have already signed up your account over Azure portal, and you want to just provide the invitation. You are just try to send the invitation to your existing Azure portal account and for the purpose of synchronization. So firstly, I'm going to show you how to create a user. Just click new and type the name of your user. Like I'm going to use my username is any name, like I'm going to use with AWS. So AWS is our username, and you need to decide the domain name. So right now my Azure Active Directory connected with two different domain, elearningplace.in, and this is my default domain. So I'm going to choose default domain name, type the display name. So I'm going to use the default display name. You need to configure the password. So proceed with your password that you plan to configure by self. We don't have any group, and you can assign the role what you want to make. This is the normal user. You want to make a contributor. You want to make an owner. A lot of options are available in role. Like what you want to make. You want to make it application master, application administrator, directory readers, and this is the global administrator, group of administrator. So as per your requirement, Intune administrator, as per requirement, you can do that. But I'm just going to proceed with normal user. This is the personal information about your user. You need to click create. Okay. So we successfully created a one user with name of AWS. This is our AWS username. I'm going to try to open our Azure portal with the help of this particular mail ID by using this name. So just copy it and open with another browser. Type your portal.azure.com. Paste your mail ID, AWS add domain name of your Azure portal. Click next. Type the password that you configured and click sign in. And you need to change your password because it's first login. And you need to authorize. This is the multi-factor authentication setting. You need to configure if you plan to log in your Azure AD user. You need to set up authentication. You need to provide a two protocol. One is your phone number and another is mail ID. You need to set up your authentication services. For the verification you are a genuine user, you need to configure it. And after that, you are able to log in your portal with the help of AWS at the rate manandrawat24@gmail.com. So you need to set up it just click here, select your location. And verify your code. the mobile number is configured successfully, authorized successfully, you need to authorize with the help of email ID as well. Now you need to open your mail ID. This is the code from Microsoft. You need to copy it and just paste and verify. Finish. Now you are able to log in with your AWS account. Just click yes. And now you successfully log in your another Azure portal with the help of user. Those users you created with the help of Azure AD Connect, Azure AD Active Directory. So this is the basic information about the user. Although you can use this particular user with multiple services. So any question about the creating user? Anyone?
From my side.
What about other?
No issues.
Okay, so next step, I'm just going to show you how we can configure the multi-factor authenticator.
So Manjit, one thing, so you added the user, right? So how about the permission? So will the user get the default permissions? And what kind of permissions you get it?
Just user, simple user. No permission we are getting.
Just so the user cannot, the user can only log in into the portal and cannot run anything, right?
Yep. You can share your services from your root account to your AWS account. You have option to share the services.
Okay.
The user will not able to create any VM or any services.
Nothing can do. You are not sharing your subscription. You are unable to do anything.
Manjit, how will you share your services as you said?
Services you can share with the help of IAM rule. So if you click on
the services. Got it.
Yeah. So you know that the IAM service, IAM access control available in the each and every services that you purchase.
Yeah, that I know. Using
Azure portal. Yep. So just try to understand about the another option which is available here. So if you plan to configure the multi-factor authentication, so in the multi-factor authentication, what you need to do, just click on the MFA. See, this is the multi-factor authentication. Click here. And it gives you the list of user, how many users you have. So we created a one user with name of AWS. You need to select AWS and just click on the enable. Enable the user and click enable multi-factor authenticator. Update successfully. I'm going to log out our account, log out our AWS user and log in again to configure the multi-factor authentication. So we activated the multi-factor authentication. That's why you are able to see this screen. And you need to type your mobile number. You need to contact number where you want to get your code or call. So I'm just going to select send a code to by text. Click here. And verify. And now the multi-factor authentication is successfully configured for your user, for your AWS user, and whenever you try to log in your portal, whenever you try to sign up yourself, you need to give the code each and every time. So this is the procedure to set up the multi-factor authentication services. Is it okay now?
So like how we enable the bulk user creation, similarly, can we do MFA for the bulk users or the whole set of users?
You can just check mark the entire user.
Okay.
Check mark it and allow the bulk.
No, I'm not saying it this way. Is it something like when we're trying to upload the Excel file itself, then and there can we enable an option to enable MFA?
NFL is managed by the customer. NFL is managed by the client. For example, you are a root account, you are an administrator. I'm working in your organization as a storage engineer. I'm able to manage the entire services related to the Azure storage part. So you just create a user, Azure user from me, and just give me the user account and password and activate the MFA. So you just need to activate. After that, okay. Each and every activity handled by the client, handled by the engineers. Admin can activate.
Okay. Got it. So
not required to make it bulk.
Okay.
What is bulk update option here?
Bulk update in the sense you can just manage, you can activate, you can select number of users. For example, you have 100 users or thousands users. You just upload the CSV file and activate the MFA for entire user. But you need to configure your MFA in the client side, like whenever you try to log in, and whenever you try to log in your Azure user, only one person can log in a single user account. No one can log in multiple user account and configure MFA one by one. Clear?
Yep.
And now next, and so this is the basic information. As you know that we have a short time, short duration, so that's why we need to understand more topics related to the IG104. So this is the first topic, and in the second, I hope I'm going to show you how we can manage the custom domain. So for the custom domain, what you need to do, you need to click on the, this is the option of custom domain. So I have already connected, but I'm just going to delete my domain and try to connect again. So now in the custom domain, we are able to see only single domains are available. This is the default. And meanwhile, I have already purchased one domain over GoDaddy.com. So I'm planning to associate my GoDaddy.com domain with the Azure portal. So this is my domain with name of elearningplace.com. I'm just going to set up this domain with our Azure portal. What you need to do, just need to open your custom domain and click add custom domain. Type the domain name, add, click on add custom domain. Type your domain name, it's a e-learning place. Dot in, click add. And you will be get a two different types of record, TXT record and MX record. You need to copy the record name, like I just type, copy the value, open your Godaddy.com account, click add, select TXT record. And like that, you need to configure your MX record as well. Type the priority. So priority is also available on AD.
So this is not an AD integrated DNS. This is standalone DNS.
Yep.
All
right. Now we successfully saved the record from our Azure portal. Just click on the verify. Now you successfully verified. And I'm just going to click on the custom domain. So now we have two different types of domain. One is a default domain, you can say that. And another is a custom domain that you purchase from the provider, from Godaddy.com or other. So this
Manjit,
is may the
know
way.
The cost of the domain that we purchase from Godaddy, any idea?
Depend upon the name, starting from 99 rupees to 5 lakh, 10 lakhs. 20 lakhs, depend upon the type. So totally based on the type of name and also type of domain. So this is the dot.
Again, it depends on depends on the time bound, right? 1 year or 2 years kind of stuff.
No. It's a time bound is a separate thing. But day one, you need to pay amount according to the name and domain.
Yeah, got it. Thank you.
So right now we are using the dot into. So it's, I think it's a 350 rupees only for 1 year.
Panchit, I have a question here.
Yep.
So if the custom domain name we had to add from our own premises, Active Directory. Directory supports AD integrated DNS. So do we need to add these records of TXT and the MX into our the domain controller DNS?
Not required. That time you need to Azure AD. That you need to download one Azure AD agent, and you need to install on your Active Directory machine. Once you install, all the domain services with domain name are directly associated with your Azure AD.
And we also need to manage the database. We also need to, you know, have the separate database server for that, if I'm not wrong with that.
No, database related to the AD?
AD Connect.
Pardon, I didn't get you.
Oh, sorry, you can go ahead.
Sorry? Can you repeat again what you want?
You can go ahead.
Okay. So this is the agenda that we discussed. So now just take 2 minutes. And check the entire activity. If you have a doubt or question, please let me know.
I think we need to cover Azure AD Connect.
We'll try.
Okay. Manjit,
talking about the completed content right now. Yeah.
Okay. No questions. So I'm asking about actually storage.
What do you want? You have so 5 minutes. Yes.
Yeah. So I want to know if we can add the on-premises storage in the in Azure storage, like NetApp or like I'm a storage engineer and I'm working on a NetApp and EMC. So can I sync Dell EMC? So can I sync up or can migrate or transfer the whole storage in the Azure?
Where is your storage? On Azure or on premises?
On premises.
And you want to synchronize with the Azure portal?
Correct. Are we able to do?
100%. This is your Dell EMC, for example.
Or we do have
Azure portal.
One. So do we have any option of selecting Azure Dell EMC or a NetApp storage while creating the storage?
Yeah, I'm going to describe you how you can attach your SAN. From those SAN are available in local office. And you are planning to connect with your Azure portal, right? Like this?
Yeah. We're planning to get and while we are selecting the storage in Azure portal, while we are creating the storage in the portal, do we have any options of SAN and NAS, selecting SAN and NAS or the NetApp storage, or you want on NetApp storage or the EMC storage in it?
All options are available over a portal.
Because basically in Azure portal we have blob storage, file storage, and page storage like that. So do we have any option of selecting NetApp storage or EMC storage, NetApp storage? That's what I want.
Yep. You have option to purchase with the help of marketplace, or if you want to connect, if you want to synchronize your on-premises storage with Azure portal, so with the help of Azure Store Simple, by using the service of Azure Store Simple, you can do that.
Okay. So this Store Simple is have to install in both the sites, like Azure portal and the local office SAN. Yeah, is that a device or an application?
No. It's just tool. It's a OVA file. You need to install your OVA file on your hypervisor machine or VMware machine. It works just like gateway between each other.
Okay, got it.
Clear?
Yeah, clear.
So this is the agenda that we did. So any question about the topic that we covered? Anyone?
No, we are good.
So due to urgent call, I need to stop the class, but definitely I'll try to give you more classes over IZ104. We'll try to give another free class maybe within 1 or 2 weeks. So I have the record, I have details about all of you, so I'll send you the mail if any free trial class schedule for all. Okay,
Manjit.
Yep,
Manjit, can I give you a suggestion? So when you are creating a YouTube videos, can you please in after the videos in the last, you can mention the questions, interview questions in it, so it would be easy. Like,
yeah, I'm planning to create like that. I'm planning to create like that. Related to the interview question, and also try to give you the details related to the openings as well. So we'll try to give you the information related to the job interview question and related to the jobs opening as well.
Okay. As you're sending the as you're creating the video, If you're creating a video on our network topic, okay, so please include the questions which they are going to ask in the interview regarding your network. So something like that, if you can include.
Sure, we'll try.
Manjeet, one suggestion from my side. You can add the real-time troubleshooting scenarios with their event IDs. Like, for example, there is a domain consolidation project going on, and after consolidation, we are checking the objective history. So these kinds of troubleshooting steps we can also add to make the information more, your videos more informative.
Because, so I request in interviews, they are always asking that,
real-time scenarios, like what is your ID, replication error, everything like that.
So if you include that, kind of questions and the scenarios, it will be good actually. And
definitely, sure, we'll try to do. Yep, thanks.
Manjeet, you were specifying about the dumps, right? So what were they? So can you share with us to at least concentrate for the exam perspective as well?
You're talking about the question and dumps?
Yeah.
Yeah, actually for AG104, we need to wait because it's a new, so I need to check with Pearson View Center. So
I have how about for AG103?
Yeah, I have an AG103, 705, 35 and 32 as well. So I have right now I have a 103.
Can you share with
me? Yep, we'll share.
Hello. Yeah. 103 is still running or they shut down the course?
It's still running due to COVID. Actually, Microsoft planning to change the AG103 certification in month of April, 1st April. But due to lockdown, due to COVID-19, postponed the certification.
Okay, right now, so running. They are going to upgrade. Yeah, Microsoft is planning to upgrade 103 to 104, or 103 is still running after 104 will
try to upgrade, just making some changes. So with
104 is the upgraded
version.
So after a few months they're going to shut down the 103, so that is the plan.
Yes.
Okay. Hello, Manjeet. Possible, just share the schedule or the content of the 104.
Okay, sure. We'll mail you.
Okay.
Thanks, Manjeet, for the wonderful session. Hope for your mail and for the
Thank you so much. My pleasure.
Thank you, Manjeet.
Okay.
Thanks a lot for the session.
Thank you, Manjeet. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Manjeet.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Instead of going only on the basics perspective, it will be great if you go beyond the basics as well, like some kind of advanced concepts as well.
Definitely, we'll try. But as for the agenda, we need to start to work with directly with the help of Active Directory. That's why I will try to give.
I would say that AD Connect or something, OIDC, something with respect to the integration or connection perspectives as well might help.
Mm-hmm. Yep, we'll try.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks,
Manjeet. Try to another free trial session, so definitely we'll try to give more related to that.
Sure. I'll be waiting for that. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.